Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Today our practical topic is to determine the differential leukocyte count, that is DLC. First of all, we must know that what are the objectives of this practical. What must you know at the end of this practical? Number one, you must be knowing by the end of this to how to prepare the properly stained film, which we will be discussing in part B of this practical. Next, you must be able to identify different type of WBCs, its clinical significance, that means that why we need to perform this practical, and again its importance. So first of all, white blood cells, WBCs or leukocytes. As you have read in your theory, there are two types of WBCs, granulocytes and agranulocytes. Granulocytes, by this name, as you can see, granulocytes, they have granules. Granules in their cytoplasm. And agranulocyte, A means absence or nothing. So these cells don't have any granules in their cytoplasm. Now, among granulocytes, you can memorize this by this mnemonic, BEN, B-E-N. B for basophil, E for eosinophil, and N for neutrophils. Now let's discuss the properties of each cell one by one. First of all, neutrophils. Neutrophils are basically the cells having 2 to 5 lobes in their nuclei. As you can see in this diagram, there are 5 lobes, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And these are blue or purple. Next, the cytoplasm has fine granules. As you can see, these are very fine granules, which are pink or red. So the cytoplasm appears pink due to the presence of these granules. Next, we have eosinophils. Eosinophils have bilobed nuclei. As you can see, this is one lobe and this is the second lobe. These have coarse granules. These are also pink, but these are coarse. That means these are rough, these are larger. So they mask the cytoplasm actually. And the cytoplasm appears almost non-visible due to the presence of these coarse granules. Next are basophils. Basophils are again bilobed. Then what is the difference between eosinophils and basophils? These both have bilobed nuclei, but the difference lies in the granules. Basophils have blue granules. And due to this, the nucleus is masked. Here, the cytoplasm was non-visible because the granules were pinkish and coarse, so they were masking the cytoplasm. Here, nucleus is blue and granules are blue as well. So these just mask the nucleus. And the cytoplasm is almost non-visible because they are large in number. The granules are large in number. Now come to the agranulocytes. Agranulocytes, again, no granules. So first, they don't have any granules. Monocytes, no granules. And lymphocytes, no granules. Then what is the difference? Lymphocytes basically have a single large nuclei. Here you can see. It's blue. And there is a rim of cytoplasm. It is the rim of cytoplasm. The nucleus covers almost 2/3 of the cell. Very little cytoplasm is present. Now monocytes. Monocytes basically have a kidney-shaped nucleus. This is the kidney-shaped nucleus. It's all blue. Again, they don't have any granules and the cytoplasm is of pink color. So when you see under microscope, you must be able to differentiate the neutrophils on the basis of their nuclei lobes, their eosinophils on the basis of their coarse granules which are pinkish, the basophils on the basis of again their nuclei, bilobed nuclei, and blue granules which will mask the nucleus. Among lymphocytes and monocytes, you can differentiate as the monocytes have kidney-shaped nuclei and cytoplasm is pink, whereas lymphocytes cover almost 2/3 of the cell and the only rim of cytoplasm is present around. Now let's come to the principle. Principle of the experiment is, we prepare a blood film with Leishman stains. We examine it under oil immersion lens to count different types of leukocytes, and then we count the percentage. It's just the basic principle of the experiment. The stain, the Leishman stain, the procedure, blood film preparation, and how to stain the slide or how to stain the film, plus the methods to count leukocytes and precautions, you will be discussing in the part B of this practical. Now, what is the significance? Why do we need to perform DLC? What is TLC and what is DLC? And what we can see in complete blood count or CBC of a patient? You see, when we talk about DLC, it means differential leukocyte count. We can count each cell line of WBC separately. And when we talk about TLC, it tells us the total leukocyte count, the number of total WBCs. And what we see in a patient's CBC, CBC is a routine blood test performed, it's complete blood count. So when you see a report of patient CBC, there is HB, there is TLC, that is total leukocyte count, there is platelets, there is MCH, and so on. And at the end, you also have DLC, differential leukocyte count, which will tell that how many neutrophils are present, how many basophils are present, how many eosinophils are present, how many lymphocytes, and how many monocytes are present. Actually, neutrophils are raised in particular infections or particular diseases. The diseases in which basophils are raised are different, and with which eosinophilia or lymphocytes are seen raised are different. So that gives us a clue that what type of infection or what type of organism is infesting in a man or a woman whom we are considering. Now let's discuss the conditions in which the each cell line is raised. One thing you must remember, that whenever there is philia at the end of the word, it means an increase, and then when there is penia, that means reduction. So when we talk about neutrophils, we discuss neutrophilia and neutropenia, the conditions in which the neutrophils are increased and the conditions in which neutrophils are decreased. First of all, we must know that the neutrophils have role in active phagocytosis, the first line of defense against infections, mostly bacterial infections, is neutrophils. So neutrophils will raise in these conditions. Some are physiological and some are pathological. Among physiological, there are severe exercise, pregnancy, after meals, and exposure to cold. And among pathological, there are pyogenic infections. Now, what are pyogenic infections? Infections which include pus formation are pyogenic infections. Mostly these are bacterial. Among these, there are tonsillitis, there is appendicitis, and so on. So you must know the conditions in which the neutrophils are increased, that is neutrophilia, and now we will discuss the conditions in which neutrophils are decreased, that is neutropenia. Again, penia means reduction. These are typhoid, malaria, aplastic anemia, some are drug induced, and some viral infections will cause reduction of neutrophils. Now let's discuss eosinophils. Again, eosinophilia means increase in eosinophils, and eosinopenia means reduction in eosinophil count. Now we know that eosinophils are mainly involved in parasitic infections and to some allergy responses. And on exam day, you must be able to answer that in which condition eosinophils are involved or what causes the increase in eosinophils or eosinophilia? Your answer would be mainly parasitic infections and some allergy reactions. Among allergy conditions, there is hay fever, then parasitic infections and some skin diseases, particularly involving collagen diseases. Next, eosinopenia, when there is reduction in eosinophil count, that is acute pyogenic infection again, and in these neutrophilia is seen and eosinopenia is seen. Aplastic anemia and ACTH therapy, you will learn about this in endocrinology. Now moving forward, basophils. Again, basophilia. Philia means again the increase in basophil count. It basically promotes blood flow due to histamine release. You must remember this with histamine release. And in the conditions in which basophils are raised are chronic myeloid leukemia or CML, lead poisoning and smallpox. Now coming to monocytes. Monocytosis. Now here there is no philia. In fact, there is the word cytosis. Cytosis also means the increase in a cell line. So whenever you see monocytosis or lymphocytosis, you must know that we are talking about the increase in the number of that particular cell. Monocytes are basically converted into macrophages. Its main function is in protozoal infections. Just the keyword protozoal infections. Now, infectious mononucleosis, it is another disease, you will learn it later. Now, lymphocytes. Lymphocytes are of two types. You must have read in your theory, T lymphocytes and B lymphocytes. Now, the conditions in which there is increase in lymphocytes is termed as lymphocytosis. And then where is reduction in lymphocytes is lymphopenia. Again, penia means low cell line or low cell count. Lymphocytosis is seen is in chronic infections, viral infections, infectious mononucleosis and lymphomas. And reduction in lymphocytes is seen in bone marrow depression and immunosuppressive therapy. By the end of this practical, you must know these basic terms or these basic conditions in which neutrophils are increased, neutrophils are decreased, eosinophils are increased or decreased, and the basic conditions in which they are involved. Eosinophils are involved in parasitic infections, neutrophils are involved in bacterial infections, it is first line of defense against infections, basophils are mainly seen due to histamine release, monocytes are increased in protozoal infection, and lymphocytes, T and B lymphocytes.
There is another key concept, Arnth count. The number of lobes in the nuclei of neutrophils is directly proportional to the age of the cell. As the cells age, the number of lobes in their nuclei increase. So the youngest cell will have one lobe and the oldest one will have five or even more. Normally, the cells with one lobe nuclei are 5%. The cell with two lobes have 30% ratio, and the one with the three lobes are maximum, that is 45%. So the counting of neutrophils on the basis of the number of lobes in their nuclei is termed as Arnth count. A shift to the left in the Arnth count means the increase in the number of younger neutrophils, that is the neutrophils that have lesser number of lobes, and it is seen in acute infections. Whereas a shift to the right means an increase in the number of older multilobed nuclei or multilobed cells, and it is seen in chronic infections and in megaloblastic anemia. Now let's have a look at the practical notebook. First, there is learning objectives, then introduction, granulocytes and agranulocytes, then there is principal and apparatus. Next, reagents and the composition of reagents. We will discuss it in part B of the practical. Then there is diagram of all the cells. Here is the color picture of cells. Next, in the table, you can see I have already explained all the differences of these cells. You must memorize them. Then there is procedure. We will discuss it in part B. the criteria of a good film and staining of film, methods of counting cell, and precautions. We will all discuss it in part B of the practical. Clinical significance we have already discussed. Then there is individual, a cell line raise and decrease, neutrophils, neutrophilia, neutropenia, eosinophils in eosinophilia, eosinopenia, then basophilia and monocytosis and lymphocytosis. Then there are questions. The first question is, what is the composition of Leishman stain? We will discuss it in part B. Again, why this stain is used, what is the criteria of a good film? All we will discuss it in part B. The clinical significance we have already discussed, the functions we have just discussed, and why the all immersion lens is used, we will discuss it in part B. Now the scenario, a 5-year-old boy is brought to the pediatric OPD with running nose, watery eyes, sneezing. These are all signs and symptoms of an allergy reaction and rash on the skin, which particularly points out towards urticaria. According to the mother, the boy was playing in a park with his friends and returned home with these symptoms. What is the cause of these symptoms? Basically, it's an allergic reaction. You can see here allergy conditions in later it is mentioned in the bracket urticaria, which particularly indicates rash. So it is a allergic reaction. Which cells do you expect to be raised? So the cells would be eosinophils. The conditions in which there is elevated count of these cells, we have already discussed, and then there is draw and label the cell under consideration. Scenario 2, a 25-year-old lady came to the emergency with high-grade fever, cough and pain on swallowing. On examination, she has large and swollen tonsils. That means she is suffering from tonsillitis. CBC was ordered immediately. So it is a typical picture of tonsillitis, and the cells raised in tonsillitis would be neutrophils. So there will be neutrophilia. Name three other conditions and then classification of leukocytes along with examples and their normal values. Now we will perform this practical in part B of the practical, and then we will discuss the remaining questions and procedure in detail.